let me just things away. I have my notepad, so it's just some notes. Then I have some notes in too. Then I have this book that I actually will need to fill out a few forms, if you don't mind. It will take just 1 second. You can meanwhile open up your textbooks and just look through them. Okay, today is the 16th of February 2012, and I'm really happy to be here. I have some forms that I need to fill out, some receipts and some. Now, this is your very first Russian language class, is that correct? Okay. Very good. Do you guys study any other language? Spanish? Okay. So this is going to be your third language. Very good. You guys enjoyed your vacation time. I sure did. Yes. Sometimes you really need it, don't you? I have some forms. Okay. I think that's about it. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. But I will complete that a bit later. Okay. Alright, so let me have a sip of water. Okay. So, Russia. Write it down, please. Natural gas and many other things. It is very important to know things about Russia because it has different cultures in it, and it has a long historic background. I could actually give you a history lesson one day if you'd like to. It doesn't have to be about Russia, but I would be glad to give you a lesson on geography or history. I also have this Russian dollhouse as a symbol of Russia. It has a beautiful face, some paintings on the bottom there, just to create a theme for you. So, Russia. Now, let me starting off explaining to you and trying to remember the alphabet sounds. Please excuse my moving board over here. It's not attached properly. Okay. So, I brought them tables, charts with me. So I will hang them. Can you see it this way? No, you can't. Very good. Okay. Now the second one. My very short one. Alright, very good. So, let me read the letters for you first. You can follow me and repeat it if you'd like to. So, it's A, B, V, G, D, Е, Ё, Ж, З, И, И, К, Л, М, Н, О, П, Р, С, Т, У, Ф, Х, Ц, Ше, твердый знак, вы, мягкий знак, э, ю, я. So let's start looking a bit closer. This is ask, but in British English form. Then, for example, a sound b, like in a word buy. V, like in a word visit. G, like in the word get. D, like in the word did. Ye is a little bit of a complex sound, so it consists of two parts, such as Y and E, like in the word yes. So that's the sound ye. Then the sound yo, it also consists of two sounds, Y and O, and it sounds like yo, like your, without an R and D. Are you following me, guys? Alright. Then a sound, Ж. Ж. You can hear, I was looking for an appropriate word, and I found the word usual. And you say the sound Ж in it. Even though it doesn't seem like it should be, it still is. So, for example, usual. Usual. And this is the Ж. Then the sound Z. Like in the zoo, for example. Then the sound E. Like a double E. It's a long E, like in a word. Free. Then the sound E. I'll actually explain this one to you a little bit better. Like you would hear in the word soy, joy, boy, anything ending with the yip. Sometimes in last names, in Russian names, you would a lot of times see ending of the last name this way. E and then Y. Why is that? Does anybody know that? The answer? That is a female form of the last name. So this is this. E and E. E and E. That will show a male form of a last name. They can be female form and male form. So in the future, if you don't know why Russian people a lot of times have this long ending, that's because it differentiates male last name from a female last name. Okay. Then a sound. Just like in your cave, like kike, anything like that. L like in lock, M like in dom, home, just the sharp M. N that looks like your age, it's actually in our language, it's in N, like in nose. Then a sound O, it's not as a soft awe, like you would have in English, but it's a sharp, long awe, like awe. In a word, auto. And not the ending awe, but that's the first two letters. Right? So, with our awe, you will need to indicate your jaw, to drop your jaw, and pronounce awe as a full sound, not just awe. Sorry for a little technical problems. So, as I was saying, that is the sound of awe. And the next sound is the sound of awe. You would hear it in a word. For example, that. The next one is the sound of re. That's the one that is so different from other languages. You will need to move your tongue to actually pronounce it properly. Like in a word, rest. But you need to roll your tongue, like in my name, for example, Maria and Maria. You can see a little bit of a difference there. Then the letter S, like in word, sun, sun, set. The letter that also very close to your pronunciation, and then like in word, desk, for example. Then the word, ooh, I'm sorry. A letter O that will sound like the word boom. Then letter fa, like the word fact. Fa, like the word home, hammer, hamster. a letter C. I found a really good example, like the word that's in the end, this ending. It's the one that sounds like a sound Z, so it's Z words. Then a sound Ch, like a word cheek. Then a sound letter. I'm sorry, I keep messing it up. I'm just a little bit nervous. I apologize. So Ch, like a word crush or rush or shampoo, anything like that. So the Ch. Then a sound sh, which is very similar to a letter sh, but it's a little bit stronger. So it's sh. The best example is when the sh is doubled, like in a word rush. This way it turns out to be close to sh as possible, even when, as an example for the Russian pronunciation. So once again, this is a sh, this is a this is not a hard sign. This is a soft sign, or make is not. These two sounds are not pronounced. They are there actually there in the speech just to soften up or harden up the sound or the letter standing behind it. This one will obviously harden it up because it's a hard sign. This one will soften up because it's a soft sign. Then the next sound. We're going to try and repeat it right now. I can only describe it in one way. If you open up your mouth and you drop your jaw a little bit, you pull your tongue to the back and try to pronounce a sound between I and U as you push your tongue from the back up into the front. Don't touch your teeth, your mouth teeth. Oy. We can try it all together. Oy. So, move your tongue from the back, up to the front, touch your teeth, and pronounce the sound in between I and G. Oy. Oy. It's a very interesting sound, I think. You'll be able to learn it over the time, but it's a very important sound, and it's used in many, many, many words. It's pretty simple, just like in the word addict. Sound U, like in the word U, and sound ya, just like in the word ya. Okay. So that's about it for the letters. Let me take it off. I'm hoping it's fun so far. I know there were a lot of requests. Please do try and learn to write.